Hello, my name is Brian, and welcome to my video travelogue of a trip I made in 2016. This trip involves shipping our Moto Guzzi bikes from Melbourne, Australia to Nijmegen in Holland. The idea was that we would ride our bikes from Holland to the factory in Mandello on Lake Como, Italy, for the 95th anniversary of Moto Guzzi. But the plan grew from one container to two and 48 bikes, which were shipped over an 8-week voyage from Australia. I hope you enjoy. So when we arrived in Nijmegen, we caught a bus out to a warehouse where our bikes were sitting to be waiting to be unpacked. And this is the process. Here's my bike, a 1974 Eldorado. And we're doing strange things like putting tape on our bikes to know what side of the road we should be riding on. Sort of thing you do when you've been worrying about riding on the right side of the road when normally in Australia we ride on the left, and it's created a lot of anxiety, but in the end we handled it all quite well.
Quarter past 12, it's 20 degrees, beautiful.
Okay, here we are, driving through Nijmegen towards Dusseldorf, hoping that my GPS is not going to lead us astray. Here we are, out of probably about 10 km's out of Nijmegen in the Netherlands, and the countryside's changed. It must be, I think, 28 degrees. Can't quite get my head around what it would be in Melbourne at the moment. It's beautiful through there.
Isn't it lovely? I didn't expect it to be like that.
Yeah. The drivers are so courteous. It's unbelievable.
Yeah.
Do you want to stop for a bit, or?
Huh?
Do you want to stop for a bit or keep going?
Not here.
No, what do you want? Like?
I'd rather be on the motorway just looking at trucks and stuff.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Why?
I'm kidding.
Oh, good.
This is just fucking magic.
Oh, thank God. I was going to say, what the fuck's wrong with you?
Nothing at all.
Yeah, no.
Ah, it's beautiful, but, you know, if you want to stop for a coffee.
I sort of can't believe we're doing this. It's sort of starting to sink in that a group of Aussies have shipped their bikes here.
No. So hopefully today's camera is a bit straighter and I have to learn to turn my head a little bit less with the camera mounted on the helmet.
So second day, we're really just in a hurry to get to Prague, and we went as far as we could on the motorway and ended up in a little town called Werther. And here we are, we've arrived at the Bohemia Club, the Moto Guzzi Club of Bohemia in Prague. This is Pavel, who spoke very little English, but we still were able to communicate somehow. They've got a dormitory for club members because it's illegal to have any alcohol and ride or drive in the Czech Republic. And as you'll see in the following still photos, Prague is beautiful. Great photographer's delight. Thank you. So in the morning it's farewell to Prague and a fond farewell to Pavel and the Bohemian Club. Thank you very much, guys.
Yeah, you're right. You couldn't get that one to come up, is that right?
No, not exactly the same. The last road was different.
I'm going to put... I'll put in the taking us. There must be another town with a...
Yeah, there was two other towns and they didn't quite match the spelling of that one on his list.
Yeah, that's what it is.
It tended to look north to me.
Yep. Thank you.
Yeah, okay, man.
Quite a bit of footage of driving out through the Czech Republic, through the rural back roads. Lots of lakes and quaint little villages, hardly any traffic, beautiful roads. Yeah, fantastic.
What's yours say? Yeah.
just before the Czech-Austrian border. There's a town called Český Krumlov. We didn't go in, but we stopped to take a photo. It looks amazing. Hello.
Thank you.
Good job.
Crossing the border from Czech Republic into Austria was like changing the channel on a TV. It was amazing. An instant change to the scenery. More of a bovine smell, the sound of clinking bells from the cattle, and very green and manicured, Nelly. leaving the campsite in the morning. My microphone is picking up the start of a bit of a problem I'm having with my left-hand header pipe has come loose, and I haven't realised it, and it's starting to thrash out the thread, which is not a good thing. More about that later.
Here we are, leaving Innsbruck. After trying to get a tyre for Tony's bike, fix a handling problem. Austria. Europe should just be called a town every 5 kilometres.
To pull up for the night and turned up at this caravan park where the lady quickly waved her hand and said no camping here tonight. It's peak season, so she pointed us towards something about 30 k's away.
Looks like we may have just found it.
Problem with my camera this day, so no footage, but we rode to Sciorg St. Marie to visit a friend of mine, John Paul, and we stayed with him for about 3 or 4 days. It was fantastic. It's great to see him.
Oh putain, Jean-Paul, j'y crois pas. Toutes les musiques que j'aime des années 70 aux États-Unis, j'arrive pas à trouver. Non. Les Zeppelin,
qu'est-ce qu'il y a encore? C'est
tout.
Yeah,
it's the 70s music. Smoking. Here's my friends smoke two packets a day, 50s. Oui. 50 and 20. And so he gave up. And then, so he could buy one new motorbike every year.
Je comprends, mais j'arrive à comprendre.
Yeah. But it hasn't stuck to it.
Okay.
Small village life. Off to the cattle markets in the morning to watch the farmers bid on cows. After lunch we walked to this castle, which is a castle owned by John Paul on a property that he has, and this castle has some history. It's a castle built by Lafayette, who helped the Americans during the Civil War. This is the largest town near Sioux Saint Marie. It's called Le Puy-en-Velay, and it's basically in a volcanic valley, and in the middle of the town you'll see volcanic spires with castles on the top, which is an amazing thing to see. Off the tourist route, but worth a visit. This guy we followed to a village a couple of k's away, and he showed us his club's get together of old French cars. It was great. Peugeot 403 coming up, which is a car I used to own. Fantastic car. So after 5 days of just relaxing and being a tourist, looking around the local district, it's time to head off to Mont Blanc to meet up with Terry and Tony. Aussie. We've got to stop here and work out which one of these coins is euro and which one is Czech krona. Anyway, up to the machine to try and work out if I can get through.
they felt sorry for me.
Tony has headed off to meet up with another friend of ours called Ian Martinez, and Terry and I have just decided to go for a ride around the Mont Blanc area, which is pretty stunning. Packed up, water bottles, flag so we know where we're from. A route through Switzerland. And my exhaust pipe that's being held on by wire.
It's a pass for their freeways. I don't even know if I need it. It's quite expensive, about $50. I don't like these big fucking drops on the side. I'm struggling to pull over in a minute, one of these cars. I don't worry about the guardrail on the end. It's not important.
point I've split away from Terry. He's gone to meet another mate of his, and I'm on my way up to meet Jan and Russell in a little French town called La Breffe. So here I am in Switzerland. I'm heading towards France to meet up with Russell and Jan, and yeah, a little bit lost, but you use the TomTom feature that allowed you to choose some of the back roads rather than the freeways, and this is the result. Fantastic road, had a great day. I've been riding for about 60 minutes along this road, not many cars, and then suddenly turned a corner and saw all these guys obviously stopping to admire the Eldorado as I rode past. Along this road, it was fantastic, and eventually stopped for the night in a town called La Breffe. I couldn't contact Russell and Jan, but they stayed in the bed and breakfast. I camped for the night, and here we are meeting up for the first time in probably about 3 weeks since we arrived in Nijmegen.
Your bike is backfiring a lot.
Yeah.
Popping and
yeah. It's ever since I put all that ethanol in there, which has got me worried. That's why I'm going to check my tappet clearances and shit like that.
Yeah.
Dan's ready to rock.
After travelling along the autobahn, we were all suddenly diverted. There must have been a large accident, and got into the largest or longest traffic jam I've ever been in. Probably 90 minutes. It was about 35 degrees Celsius, and really uncomfortable. So I punched into the TomTom to find the nearest back route, and this is where it took me, on an amazing road that was nearly like a service road for all of the windmills. Fantastic.
Oh, another church.
Here's our stop for the night, Bergen in Germany on the Rhine, and had one of the best meals of my whole trip here. I had wild boar goulash. Well, I'm pretty sure that's what it was, because we didn't speak German and they didn't speak English.
Leopard skin bike with a leopard on it.
So today we wanted to take a diversion to go to Louis, which is a big motorcycle accessory dealer in Europe, a chain store, and yeah, this is where Jan bought her new Schubert helmet. So today is an exciting day. It's the start of the main reason we went to Europe, where we meet back with all of our friends to start the 8-day tour to Mandello to go to the factory, the Moto Guzzi factory, for their 95th anniversary, leaving Nijmegen, and yeah, great anticipation. So here we are very early in the morning, around 7 a.m. Getting ready to leave, getting a briefing from the guys from TLM. It's about 68 Aussies, and the rest of them are Dutch and Germans and basically from anywhere, all over Europe.
k's out of Nijmegen. 50 k's out of Nijmegen.
We didn't really know the route. We'd had it emailed to us to put into our tom-toms as we were riding in the weeks earlier. And so, yeah, a bit of a surprise. We suddenly found ourselves riding past the Nürburgring. Amazing for an Aussie to find themselves by surprise just going past something that they've heard so much about and read so much about.
Pretty cool.
At our first hotel in a town called Bad Kreuznach, I think that's how you say it, on the Rhine. Interesting night with some interesting service from the people who own the hotel, but great night we had.
Good morning. Where are we?
Check it back. You do not have to kiss the phone.
quick swap with Pierre. This is Pierre riding my Eldorado, so I get to see my Eldorado from behind, and yeah, I think he was pretty happy to give it back because my front tyre was well and truly gone. I diverted onto the Autobahn, which was an option for us at any time to try and get through the day. A few neck issues I was having, but anyway, best laid plans, huge traffic jam, which was not uncommon on the Autobahns. Then you'd come across the blockage and you'd find that it was something they were taking their time about clearing, which surprised you because some of these traffic jams were like 20 k's long. So after two huge days of riding, this is our third day and final day into Bazio, Italy, above Lake Como.
Apparently nothing.
Again, playing the tourist, just happened to be riding through St. Moritz and stopped for a few photos. are in what ends up being the entrance to Italy, and it's a one-way tunnel, so you sit here waiting for the light to turn green and off you go, and vice versa, the traffic comes the other way.
Oh, it's fucking freezing in here.
To Italy, so we obviously stopped for the mandatory photo. So finally we arrive at our final destination, about 30 k's above Mandello in the hills, which is about an hour's ride in very windy conditions. Beautiful hotel, no English, amazing vine, must have been 100 years old, growing up through the hotel. So day four, our first look at Mandello, the ride down from Bazio.
There's Lake Como. This is the train station. Well, my clutch cable broke just as we went to take off. In 20 minutes we had a new cable from a shop and installed by Pierre. What a legend. Lake Como. Beautiful. It's very hazy. I think it's probably because they've had this incredible hot spell and no rain to clear anything away for like 4 weeks. This place is just the photographer's delight. Fuck me.
Tunnels around the lake are amazing, as you can see, but just coming out of the tunnels, you're just greeted with these new vistas. It's just amazing. Very dark, like no lighting. And another photo. Mandello Dallario. So this is a Saturday of the festivities, and what you're going to see now is just a whole lot of still images that I've taken as I'm walking around seeing all these amazing bikes and enjoying what is just an amazing celebration. Everyone well behaved, everyone smiling. It was just fantastic. So after an amazing weekend, quite a few of us decided to stay in Mandello for the week, which was the right decision. It was a fantastic time. And here, Paul Wise on his 1979 1000 SP, which he flew in 1979 to Italy to buy, and now he's taken it back there. Amazing story. And Russell on his Stelvio, and myself on the Eldorado, we go for a ride on, around the lake to see the town of Bellagio, which is rumoured to be where George Clooney lives some of the year. Bellagio, we stopped at Lecco, which we'd ridden through a few times and didn't think much of, but this time we rode along the waterfront and it was quite beautiful, so we stopped and took some photos. We basically chilled in Mandello for a week and caught up with some rest and relaxation. And one of the days it rained, and so the mist that was hanging around cleared up, and I took the opportunity to go out with the camera and get some photos. And on the last day, Russell and I decided to go and have a look at the museum without all the crowds. Thank you.
anymore.
I tried to do a conversion the other day.
Thank you.
Of,
So after the excitement of staying in Mandello for the week, I had to fly up, ride up to Cologne and spent the week there, went to a big trade show called Fotokina, which was great, and here I am just riding out of Fotokina, looking at the cathedral one more time before leaving. End of the trip, we all met back in Nijmegen and stayed for 3 days, and one of the big tasks was taking the bikes out and packing them back into the containers ready to ship back to Australia. We're all feeling a bit tired and I suppose still elated, but also a bit sad that the trip's nearly over. So the last few days we just chilled around Nijmegen, and that was fantastic. We all enjoyed it much more than we expected. Beautiful place, a lot of history, very calm, chilled locals, and then I took the train in to Amsterdam and spent about 4 hours in there, ran around with my camera trying to find some photos and just soak in a bit of the atmosphere. Back to Nijmegen and just a couple more photos showing the bikes and some of the historic sites around the town. Well, to date, that is the trip of my lifetime. Shipping my old 1974 Moto Guzzi Eldorado to Europe and riding around for 7 weeks. Wow, what a blast. It's amazing. Editing this has been a huge job, but actually a lot of fun going back and looking at it all again. So, ciao for now.